Hello students, welcome back to our second video on electric field. In the last video we had discussed the definition of electric field and definition of electric field intensity. Today we are going to understand some key aspects of electric field. Students, electric field is not merely a mathematical construct. It is a physical entity. It is actually present. It is not so that we have defined the electric field in terms of mathematics only. It is a reality that a charge produces electric field which travels up to the second charge and exerts force on it. Like I have this rubbed straw, I bring another rubbed straw near it, and I bring it near it, they are exerting force. It has been found that if we have a charge, say capital Q, at some distance small r from another charge, and we displace this capital Q by some distance, say delta x, the information that this charge has displaced will be carried by the electric field moving to charge small q. This information takes a finite time to reach small q, and that time t is r by c, because c is speed of light and it is the speed with which electric field travels in empty space. One more thing, test charge is to be taken by default always positive. We never take test charge as negative. Electric field, although defined operationally in terms of Q naught, is independent of Q naught. You recall, electric field due to a point charge was 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square for point charge. This is defined for point charge in terms of Q naught, but the final expression is not carrying Q naught. Q naught was cancelled in the final expression. You recall the basic definition of electric field was limit Q naught approaching 0 F vector by Q naught. We had in the last video also told that electric field is a vector quantity. What about the direction? Direction of electric field, you see this expression E vector, limit Q naught approaching 0, F vector by Q naught. Direction of electric field is always same as the direction of force on positive test charge. If source charge is positive, then the test charge, it is by default positive, force on that test charge will be repulsive. Therefore, we say electric field of positive source charges radially outward. I have shown it here. These arrows, they are showing direction of electric field vector. Obviously, at different points, the direction of electric field vector will be different. But I have E1 vector, here E2 vector, here E3 vector. But their magnitudes, they are same. Since distance of FP point is R, if source charge is Q is negative, electric field will be radially inwards. I have not shown it here, but if I have a negative source charge, all the electric field direction will be inward. And electric field due to a point charge is spherically symmetric. What do we mean by spherically symmetric? It means if we draw a sphere of a fixed radius small r with center as the source charge, the magnitude of electric field everywhere on the surface of sphere will be same. Hence, electric field of point charge is spherically symmetric. Note that when we say electric field of point charge is spherically symmetric, magnitude of electric field is same everywhere on the surface of sphere, note the direction of electric field. And lastly, mathematically, in the last video we had discussed that we should keep a test charge which is vanishingly small. Mathematically, since in the final result the test charge has to cancel, therefore the electric field is simply force on a unit charge or force on one coulomb charge. Although when we start doing its experiment, then taking one coulomb charge may not give correct results because one coulomb charge is very large and it will otherwise modify the source charge distribution. Students, in this video we had talked about the various modifications of electric field. One more thing which I want to tell, we are going to frequently use a notation of a uniform electric field. So uniform electric field is an electric field whose magnitude and direction is same everywhere. It is represented by equidistant parallel straight lines with arrows in the direction of the electric field. Uniform electric field means magnitude and direction of electric field is uniform throughout space. It is represented by equidistant parallel straight lines. If we keep an external charge, say a proton, in an external electric field, then what will be the force on that charge? Suppose we have a uniform electric field and we keep a proton on which there is a positive charge. The force on proton is given by the charge on proton into electric field. It is just a reverse of this equation. Only difference is place of test charge, we are now having the external charge. Had this test charge been an electron, it would have a negative charge. In that case, the formula would have remained the same. But since the charge Q would be negative, then force F vector would be opposite to E vector, that is electric field. In this diagram, electric field is towards the right. Force on proton will be towards right because Q is positive, F vector is parallel to E vector. So we understand if Q is positive, it implies F vector is parallel to E vector. And for electron, the force on electron will be opposite to force on, opposite to the direction of electric field. If Q is negative, it implies F vector is equal to minus Q E vector. That is, F vector is opposite to E vector. Note this point carefully. In the yesterday's definition, we were using test charge and force, direction of force on test charge was the direction of electric field. If we are given direction of electric field, we can calculate force on any charge. It can be positive or it can be negative. On positive charge, force will be in the direction of electric field, and on negative charge, force will be in the direction opposite to electric field. Thank you.